Hello Librans, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and these are the readings for the month of October, the first half of October, and they are all general readings which may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you're dealing with, or they may be the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation, and if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign and your name sign, which is according to the first alphabet of your name. Okay, and if you want a personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. Okay, so Librans, with the Knight of Wands, you want to rush in very passionately towards something. There is something new with the Page of Wands also. There is something new, there is something youthful, something you are passionate about, something you really like, and you are moving ahead, or at least you want to move ahead in a very positive direction, in a very enthusiastic way. That is what I think, and this is something which is giving you a youthful energy, something which makes you feel fresh. It can be a relationship, it can be a work project, it can be anything, but it is something you are ready to, or sort of a get set go type of an energy with both these cards. Okay, you are ready to embark on a new journey, you are ready to move on to the new journey, and with the Ace of Swords, you are very passionate about it. Your vision is clear, your thoughts are clear, you have a clarity of thought, and it is a success. You will be successful in that, and it is followed by the Hierophant. That is why I feel, is it about some relationship? Are you moving passionately into a relationship? Because Hierophant here is, it can be, there's nothing to take advice or something. It look over here, it gives me the vibe of being it is a marriage counselor, a priest, or a marriage, a commitment, engagement, whatever it is. That is what I am getting. Okay, so you are very passionate about something which makes you feel very good, very youthful, and you want to move forward. You have the clarity, you know this is right for you, and maybe you will move forward with it, and you will be blessed by the Hierophant, and it is a solid commitment, it is a stability. But then I really don't understand this. There is a Tower and there is Eight of Swords. Either something has happened which has stopped you from moving forward, or will stop you from moving forward. And because with the Eight of Swords, you are held up. Something from your past is holding you behind. Past experiences, some bad experiences, bad influences of your past, which have left you shattered. I think it is not, maybe something, it is not that something has happened right now. Maybe it has happened for some of you, some belief system, some thought process, something has really happened which has shaken you up. And because of that now you are, because of that experience, basically from these two cards, what I want to say is, maybe it has happened right now, it has happened in the past, maybe you were moving very good and then it happened, so you've stopped, or it is, everything is very positive, but something is holding you back. Maybe something is holding you back. It is the some bad experience is there, I think, in the past, in the recent past, or maybe many years back, that I don't know, but it is holding you back. You feel tied up. You feel tied up. You hold yourself back. You don't move forward, though the path ahead is open. You are so much hurt by that experience that you do not have the guts to move forward, I think, now. Now, you are totally blind. You have just taken a blindfold. You just don't want to move forward. Rather, you feel so tied up with some energy. Though you can easily move forward, you can just free yourself easily from this energy, though you are not. This is the very contrast. Either it is two people I am dealing with, energies of two people maybe, or this Tower has happened. Something is holding you back from this energy. That is what I am trying to say. It is how it is supposed to be grouped. This is perhaps what you want, and this is perhaps which is holding you back. That is what I can say. If you come out of this negative situation and come out of these swords or negative, because the route over here is open, you can see the path ahead is open. There is no sword ahead in front of this lady. It is not gender specific, but still she is not moving forward. She is so tied up. So something is holding you back. Something has really happened. You have a bad experience. you really have a bad experience. Obviously, it is in the past. I don't think it is. It has already happened. And that is why you are not able to receive this energy for those of you. Or you are, yes, though you want it. Maybe it is a conflict between your heart and the head, heart and the brain. Perhaps this is a conflict between the heart and the brain. This is what you want. You want to move passionately. Everything you, what you want is there. But something is holding you back, Librans. With the Seven of Hearts, it's about secrets, imaginations and new feelings. Perhaps if it's something, if it is a relationship, something is holding you back. Maybe they are, you are keeping a secret from that person. You have feelings for that person. You imagine that person, but you don't want to tell that person. Can be that. That is what I am getting now. Let me see what the guardians have to say. It is a time for you to step up and be the leader. Your natural leadership skills are being called into action. This is the moment in the sun to see the light and shine. For all to see, this is the card. It's all about a person who has charisma and is inspiring, enjoys a challenge and loves the spotlight. So, see, maybe this is the time for you to speak up. Maybe you are not able to take a stand. Okay, maybe you are not able to take a stand. Maybe you need to step up, be a leader for yourself, speak up for yourself so that you are able to do you. There's no, maybe there's something you have to tell somebody and you are not telling somebody. You have to take a stand. You have to speak up. You have to take a stand. Only then you will be able to come out of it. You have to take a stand. You have to be strong. You have to come out of this situation so that you are able to reap the benefits of this situation. Okay, let me see what the Whispers of Love has to say. 443 may be of some significance for you, or number 7 may be of some significance for you. Love endures. Love does not give up or lose faith. Love is hopeful and withstands every situation. So if it is a love situation, you should understand if something negative has happened, you should understand that love can endure everything. And it is the only positive thing on this earth, which, or in this universe, I should say, which will help you to come out of any negative situation. Just see, this is all about personal power. This line over here, the couple is sitting over here. And this is, and these are all turbulent emotions. The emotions, the waves of these turbulence in the ocean is all about the turbulence of your emotions. And but just see the clarity of the sky. Just see how serene the sky is. So basically, if you have that personal power, the couple is ready to sail through the turbulent waters. So no matter what the hardships are, no matter what has happened, you need to understand that if you are in a position of love, if you are in a positive situation, things will. You will be able to tide over this negative situation. Okay, there is a contrast of emotions over here, Librans. See, something negative is holding you back. Please come out of it, Librans. Please come out of it. You should understand that love can endure everything. Love can endure everything. You have to set yourself in a positive situation so that there is no point in keeping quiet and keeping your feelings a secret. You need to take a stand and speak up. Come on, Librans. That's all I have for you, and please like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.